What is up, guys? Me like here today. We're back in action on another Rise SMP, and today is 100% work on the Guardian farm over there. It's freaking fantastic. So if you guys enjoy this video, make sure to go ahead and click that like button. It really help me out, and I love your faces even more than I already do. So today we do a lot of cool stuff. I kind of go mentally insane halfway through because I work on this for almost 30 hours straight. And I ruined my sleeping schedule, so like I started like 10 p.m. and then I worked maybe even less than that, maybe like 8 p.m. and I worked all night and then all day until about probably 11 p.m. again. So I worked probably close to 30 hours on this, 24, 25, mid-20s. So yeah, I work on this straight for a lot of time, and it's awesome. I get so much progress done. The farm isn't done completely, but it's looking pretty sweet. So, also, halfway through, we talk about some life stories, and we just kind of basically chillax and build, and it's a pretty awesome episode, if I do say so myself. And, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and, pause it here, and you guys get to see all the cool stuff that I do. And hopefully you guys enjoy, and hopefully you're having a fantastic day, and I love you so much. I love you so much. Okay, you're still tied up. This guy's been like, freaking untying himself. Like he's gaining intelligence. It's the horse uprising. Hashtag horse uprising. Ah, I'm freaking weird. Okay, hope you guys enjoy. This server is sponsored by Court Servers. Links in the description below. What's up, guys? So today we're going to be working on some cool stuff. I've actually been doing a crap ton of work over there. We'll go check that out here in a second. But let's see. Have I done anything else different here? I can't remember if I showed this off, but I have a track that goes all the way down here, down to the bottom thing. I haven't been working on this. I've actually switched my my grind back over there to the underwater Guardian farm or whatever, but I do have this guy right here that's I've been working on. I think I showed that at the end of last episode, maybe, or the beginning of last episode, I'm not sure. But yeah, I've been doing all kinds of stuff over at the Guardian farm. Let's go check that out. As far as the base is concerned here, I haven't done too much. I think I might make one of these little room for maybe like some stuff here. I don't know, I might make both of these little rooms right here. I'm still kind of thinking about it. Let's exit out here. So, alright, what are you doing, man? Here, come here. Come here, Shadow Steed 2. Shadow Steed the second. stupid horse. And then we got Adam and Eve here. They haven't started repopulating the planet yet, which is nice. I have a crap ton of stuff here, just in there for no freaking reason. Also, I wanted this to be a little protected, so like this whole area here is kind of protected. So I dug the mountain out a little bit and did a little fence action, and then I actually brought the cart that comes all the way up here, and I did this cool little thing. I feel like it looks better than just. It feels like this is actually kind of completed now, like and stuff. So I don't know. I think I'm gonna actually extend this out farther this way and maybe build like a little wall or something, maybe like from like break the down the mountain right here and do a wall like all the way around like this. I'm not sure, and maybe do my gardens and stuff here inside of like a little protective wall. That might be kind of cool. We might actually work on that today. I'm not sure. I actually just kind of thought of that. I was thinking about a wall, but I never really thought about doing it all the way around. So yeah. And then let's come all the way over here. I probably should have taken my cart. That's like the entire point of my cart. I actually need to build a tunnel that goes through this little hillside as well. And I'll probably move this whole thing. Actually, I was thinking, since we're gonna have a tunnel that goes through here to the Guardian farm, and we have this guy, I might actually build like a little station here, maybe like a little rest stop station thing. That might be kind of cool. And then you'll stop and park, and then you'll have to actually get out, come over here, and start up again. I don't know. That's a future project, though. I think it'd be pretty neat. If you guys have any suggestions for that, then comment down below. It'd be freaking amazing. I've been a naughty boy. I've worked on this a lot. Like I've got a lot of stuff done. A freaking lot of stuff. Like today I've been working for a bajillion hours and it's been amazing. So I decided like I was gonna have like just a straight up vertical wall here, and then like you'd go underneath and you'd kind of like see this as like in the middle here, but I decided that was way too much work. And this still is going to look freaking awesome. So I decided to do like some kind of like step down stadium thing here. I'm not exactly sure, but it goes all the way around, and this took forever. Like, stairs are a giant pain in the butt because it's all blank air underneath here, so it's not like I was placing it on a block or anything. So a lot of these stairs kind of really suck balls. but yeah, it goes all the way around, and then we have this. Oh god, this requires so much glass. Like, it really, and I'm planning on using more glass too. See, the way this is gonna work is, this right here is actually the top, and then it's going to go, like, imagine there's a, I'm standing on a block right now, like, up here, but right here, so starting from this cobble, down five blocks is going to be glass, and then underneath that's going to be another, prismarine border here, and then, I might just take out all the wall underneath that, and then do a little action underneath. I don't know, I'm still kind of playing with it. You guys probably didn't understand what I just said, but that's what it looked like, the prismarine right there. Then go down about five where this white marble is, and then at the very bottom will be another prismarine, and then you'll probably be able to go underneath of this or something. I was actually thinking about having like a glass walkway on that, like right underneath of here, that you could walk around the outside, because this is all going to be filled up with water right here, the first five layers, and then underneath this it's going to be air, and then like I'll set up a thing that pushes the guardians towards the middle and does all kinds of cool stuff like that. But yeah, this is what we have so far. I figured instead of just like building all of it or something, I'm going to update you. I don't know what clip this video is going to be in, because I might I was thinking about making like the thing one whole episode of just working on this, or I might stick this clip in with something else. I'm not sure yet, but yeah, this is the progress I have so far, and I'll be back, like, you know, after I make some more progress. I would do some fast forwarding bits, but I don't really have a lot of hard drive space at the moment, so actually, what a capture card I feel like would be really good, useful for, is if I had a capture card, I could just kind of like press a button and record, and it would automatically encode it for me, so I wouldn't it would be a really small file format, and I could just get like huge file or super long files, and it would only be a couple gigs instead of having like a gig a minute or something. Anyways, I'm gonna pause it here, and I'll see you guys here in a second. Okay, so we're at spawn. I want to make a couple diamond pickaxes because mine are gone. Let me do some of this action here. There we go. Boom. A couple diamond pickaxes, and we're gonna see where we get. I'm just gonna straight up enchant them. I'm not really gonna worry about it. I don't have lapis, and I'm pretty sure. So I actually helped Krillic move into his new house, like in the desert. It's pretty far away, and thankfully he like left some lapis here. I keep stealing his freaking lapis, but that's fine. Yeah, we're gonna enchant some stuff. I really need some pickaxes. I completely destroyed mine. So we're going to fully enchant some. Oh, yes! Yes! Oh, here we go. Oh my god, that is a perfect pickaxe! Holy balls! I needed a silk touch so much! So freaking much! Oh my god, perfect. Freaking perfect. That kind of sucks. I really want efficiency. I really wanted efficiency. Power 4? No, that's... I don't want power 4. Dang, I was hoping that'd be like efficiency or something. That would've been sick. Man, I could have a chance of being something else as well. I really wanted efficiency with that. Not sure. But it'll have to do for now, I guess. But this silk touch is amazing. I can use this for ice. I was actually trying. I was hoping I would get a silk touch. So yeah, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna meet you guys back at the thing over there. It's gonna be freaking sweet. Okay, guys, we're back for a little update on what we've been doing on this so far. So as you see, I've been working pretty hard. I kind of got a lot of this done, about down seven layers or so. The glass goes down five, and that's actually going to be where the water is, where the guardian spawns. So back behind here is kind of like a viewing area. I've been working on this. It looks kind of like a stadium a little bit, but we have this little stairway that kind of goes down. I'm still working on it. I figured we could actually probably work on it together, And you're going to be able to, like, walk around here and view inside, view all the Guardian spawning. And this is going to be, like, the stairways that go kind of partway down. I'm not exactly sure how I want to go all the way down. But what's going to happen is water's going to go... The water's actually only going to be on the top layer here, and I'm going to need to get a bunch of dirt or something easy to break and spread it all on the second layer of glass down, spread it all the way across right here, and then put get some ice, which is what the silk touch is going to be used for. Get some ice and plant it all the way down in an L shape all the way down here. It'll spread all the way across, and I'll need to kill all the dirt, and then all the water will flow down. So whenever Guardians spawn in the water, they'll flow immediately down, and like the water ends where these signs are going to be, and they'll fall through the signs, and then we'll have a way to collect them in the middle and all that kinds of cool stuff. So yeah, I'm still kind of working on the specifics, but this is how it's going to work. Let's go over here and let me grab some glass. I as you guys see, I moved all the chests down. I have them kind of organized. There we go. 1, 2, 3. I'll grab 3 stacks of glass. I'm sure that'll be fine. So let's come over here. I'm gonna work on the little stadium, like stairway or whatever together. I think it'll be pretty sweet. Hey guy, stay away from me. Let's see. So I think that'll be good. And then we probably want to just maybe cap this off up here. Yeah, that'll be fine. That'll be nice and dandy. And then, let's see. And then we probably want to bring... Here, let me drink this water breathing potion real quick. And then I'm going to make sure that our brightness is all the way up. And we're going to come out here a little bit. So we want this to go probably 1, 2, 3. So we want to go 1... let's see. 1. Let's go ahead and just put all these blocks. I hate... Oh man, this whole build has been making me sick of doing stuff underwater. It really sucks. But once this is done, it's going to be so worth it. And I'm going to try to make it look as nice as possible, because if I don't make it look nice, then it's going to bother me. I actually kind of regret doing this out of stained clay, but I'm going to build it so you won't be able to see the stained clay unless like you're up above. And even when you're up above, you can't really see it that well. And then I really like the glass features. I like being able to see out into the ocean. I'll probably add some of those features over there to my actual base. And actually, this whole thing here is really going to be part of my base. Once I build a tunnel that goes from the base all the way over here, this is going to be part of it. And I think I'm going to stick my dedicated enchanting setup over here, because I'm going to make a way. I know the Guardians have thorns, so they hurt you. But I'm going to make a way to get an experience from them by... there's the old-fashioned way of throwing a potion, which I actually might build... my brewing room over here too. Now think about it, because I'm going to make it so it's going to be like a typical spawner where they fall down so many blocks and they're dead, or one block right above them and they're just like one hit away, so I can just throw a freaking potion of harming, or I can punch them. Punching them might hurt me and my armor, so I was thinking about doing a beacon setup, but now that I think about it, a potion of harming would probably just be better, like just kind of let them build up and then throw the harming on them. If I had a looting sword, I don't know. We'll have to play with it. We'll have to play with it, see what we want to do, what kind of features we want to add to it. I'm going to go ahead and add some black stained glass right here. And then I have this so it kind of wraps around, which, well, I'm doing this wrong, aren't I? Yep, I'm doing this wrong. Yeah, and doing this underwater sucks so much balls. Like, it really does. But, like, I think, like I said before, I think the final outcome of this is going to be freaking amazing. I'm going to love it so much. And then, like, using the sponges kind of sucked, too. Like, without the sponges, like, it would be horrible. Like, this whole process would have probably, like, been impossible. It would have taken me months just going, like, layer by layer, clearing the dirt. Like, I would have needed all the guys' help just to... do this in a reasonable amount of time. But stupid. Oh man. I've been loving life doing this so far. It's been amazing, but I think it's going to be rewarding. Once I get done, it's going to be like I built a freaking Guardian spawner and it was amazing. So I think I'm going to really like it. Okay, so I kind of got the glass wrapped around the back here, I had to remove the top layer of glass because I changed the height of the thing here, but there we go. That's all we got to do. Now I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the water. That's why I love sponges so much. They're so good. then we have a beautiful little thing here, except for there's still some stuff lying around everywhere, so it's not quite as beautiful as what I thought it'd be. okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get, oh wow, that was a lot of extra stuff here. Is it dry now? Yes, it is. Nice. Ah, see? Dang. How do I want to do this? Let's do a little bit of this action. We'll go ahead and place polished andesite right here. And it's going to look freaking fantastic. And then I guess really I need to build the wall up right there, or I could just leave it the way it is. Let's see. Let's kind of walk down into it. So we got the stairs here. We walk down. It's a little viewing area, and we kind of walk into this thing right here, which is, oh, there's some more blocks. Sweet. I don't know. Not sure. Let me go ahead. Let me fix this guy right here. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. Dang it, I don't have any more andesite on me. I could. Let me get up here. Let me do a little bit of this action. We'll see what this looks like when it's kind of fully enclosed. I think that'll make it look more complete, really. And then I need to get some lights in here as well, some sea lanterns. But I'm out of sea lanterns, so this is what it's going to look like right here. And then for some reason it's odd. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. So we're gonna have to make this even like that. And then I'm assuming we'll have a step down, so maybe like some stone brick stairs or something. Maybe, I don't know. We'll have to see. Now let me place some torches down here so we don't get some spawns. There we go. Perfect. Yeah, I think this looks good. I'm going to go ahead and pause it again, guys. I know I keep doing some quick cuts, but I'm going to pause again. I'm going to work on this a little bit more, and then I'll probably go to sleep here soon. So maybe the clip you guys see next will probably might be tomorrow or something. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, I'll see you guys here in a second. Okay, we're back, guys. So I've been working on this a little bit. I built the wall down some more, probably another 7 blocks maybe. Drained out the water. I've been killing this wall right here. I got all of this tunnel right here done, so this is done all the way around, which is pretty sweet. Like I said before, this is going to be a little viewing area. I still need to build the stairs and all the other three sides, but it'll be something in the future that would do. I have like a really ghetto rigged way to get down here. There we go. yeah, so I've drained out the water in more on some of these sides more than others, just because it, like, we have these weird mountains in the ocean that I'm gonna have to take care of. Once I get the wall all the way down, I'm gonna drain all the water. I'm gonna have to deal with all the hills and stuff, but we're almost there. We've done about half of the work, and when I say we, I mean me. I've done about half of the work here, so I have about double what I've done since the last clip left to do, as far as like clearing all this out and getting all this done. And then I'm gonna place all the dirt up here and do all the signs. And signs is going to be a giant pain in the butt, but I'll get it done, and it's gonna be freaking amazing. And yeah, see right here we have like this these little hills and stuff that I need to take care of. But yeah. So that's pretty much all I wanted to update you guys on. Just kind of show you some progress in between. Also, as I've been kind of digging this out and doing this sort of thing, I've been watching CSGO on Twitch. So I've been just kind of chillaxing watching Twitch. And I might start trying to play some CSGO. I bought it. I always grew up playing Halo. I never really played Counter-Strike because I never had like a PC when I was really young to play games. Which I guess, when I say really young, I guess, let's see, Counter-Strike is what, like 12 years old now? So I would have been 12 years ago, I would have been 14, so yeah, definitely not. I didn't really get a PC that I could play games on until I got to, like, I was a freshman in college. And so, yeah, I guess I always played Halo, so I was big into Halo. I'm a freshman year of college. I played, that's actually how I met German, man. Freshman year of college, we met playing Halo, Halo 3. I just got an Xbox, and then like I just started playing Halo 3, and then we met online, and then like 2 years later I actually went out and visited him, and then here we are 8 years later now. I'm 26 now, 8 years later, and yeah, been friends ever since. So yeah, Halo brings people together. if you guys play CS:GO or maybe any sort of like Call of Duty or whatever, then make sure to comment down below. I'd like to hear your stories. But I love Halo so much. It's amazing. I'm really excited about the Master Chief Collection. It's going to be pretty sweet. But yeah, I think I just wanted to update you guys. I think I'm going to go ahead and kind of continue digging this, and then we'll see how much more I get done tonight. And I'll keep updating you guys periodically and see, you know, how everything is going. Okay, guys, we're back again. I swear I've been working on this stupid Guardian farm for like 15 hours straight. It's probably been pretty close to 15 hours, maybe even longer. I'm not exactly sure, but this is what we have so far. I've cleared out this entire wall was like stone and stuff. I finally got that. Almost all the water is gone. And this is the last section of water that I have, and I just gotta have to fill this up with prismarine, and then we'll be good. But I've been working this so long, but we're getting super close, guys. I'm getting excited about getting this done. I think the next step, really, is once I kind of slab all this up and clean up all this, and like it looks all pretty and stuff. I don't even think I'm gonna worry about the stairs on all four sides tonight. But I'll probably still, I'm going to put like a mix of cobble and dirt, whatever I freaking have, up on the second layer of glass right there and bring it all the way across. And then probably the next clip will be us like at spawn. I'm going to make a little ice farm or whatever, and it'll be us getting some ice. I don't really need that much. I need about, let's see, probably about two stacks, because each of these lines is about a stack of items. So, yeah, so probably about two, maybe two and a half stacks of ice. It's not going to be that much. Then we'll lay it down, and then we'll break it. And then, well, I guess I need to get the signs done first. Oh, my God. The signs, it's going to be so horrible. I need to build, like, supports. I did have a couple rows of cobblestone where I got this done right here. But I was like, yeah, screw this. I'm not, this, I started doing this before I even, I think even like this, like when I was working on the underglass part here, which was so long ago. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and I feel like this whole video is just like clips of like progress of this and how it's going. But I've been working this just straight watching Twitch TV. My butt hurts really bad right now. it's lost all of its circulation. But yeah, I've just been watching Twitch. I'm still watching Counter-Strike, and I'll see you guys here in a second, I guess. 18 hours for me. Okay, guys, I'm back, and I've completely ruined my sleeping schedule. I've been up all night, and now it's like 4 p.m., so I'm going to end up staying up all day and then hopefully straighten my sleeping schedule back up. I've been working on this all freaking night, so this is probably like over mid 20 hours that I've been working on this kind of pretty much straight. It's not done, but we have basic farm set up, so thanks to this guy I found online. So I was going to do this way more complicated, and I was having problems figuring out how I wanted to direct the guardians into a single path and stuff, because I was going to do a single 5-thick area where guardians could spawn, and then they would kind of fall through and get directed by water. And then it didn't really look that good, because the water underneath kind of ruined it. And I didn't want to use carts or anything, because that would just overcomplicate things and require a lot of resources and probably end up lagging the server. So I found this guy. I linked his video down below. He's a small guy, so go check him out. Subscribe if you like his videos. I don't think he's aware. I liked his video earlier. I don't think he's aware that I watched the video, and I don't even know if I'll bring any attention to him. But he has a good voice. He has a good mic. He has a low amount of subscribers, so he might be worth checking out. Tell him MediaLock sent you. Pretty much he had an idea. It's a simple idea, like it's used for a lot of farms, is multiple spawning platforms. And the way this works is each of these spawning platforms is 7 wide, so the water keeps going down, and then this is 8 wide, so it stops right here at the edge. And I put these signs here, just I don't know if it helps, or maybe the guardians won't try to swim back up and they'll think, you know, whatever. I still need to do the corners, or I could just leave the corners, I'm not sure. But yeah, so it goes down. Before we break the water here, I do want to check out, I've made some changes to this. So this is actually smaller, which I didn't really like it. being smaller, but there's not really much I could do about it. I wanted to get the best possible spawning platforms. So in this instance, aesthetics or mechanics is overruled aesthetics. I didn't really want to do it, but I did it anyways. So this is a little bit smaller, but that's fine. It's fine. I'm not too worried about it. So let's find the ladder down, and we'll kind of check it out. And I did kind of make a mistake. I built the top first. That was my mistake. So it's going to be kind of a pain building the layers down now because I'm going to have freaking zombies and all kinds of stuff after me, and it's going to be crazy. So I just made it harder for myself to build down. So that's not the greatest thing ever. I got feather falling. I'm not too worried about it. But it looks pretty sweet. I went over to German's and snagged some of his crystals and that kind of stuff. Also snagged some ice and stuff from him, and then I've been getting some ice from Spawn. Krillic has a little basic one. I didn't really need that much ice, just I think 2 stacks, so four stacks, not that much. Right, I haven't set up like the way to kill them or anything right now. I'm just going to kind of punch them because I've used over a double chest of prismarine bricks and normal prismarine, and I have about a half of a double chest of each left, and that's just from the temple itself. So I just set up a little basic spawner. What I'm going to do is probably just sword them to death and have their goodies come to here. Maybe next time, or maybe in a few episodes, I'm not exactly sure when, I'm going to set up an automated system. I'm not sure if I want the, if I want them, so I want to do it so where you can, they can either fall to their death, or, well, not fall to their death. I was just going to set up like a lava trap, I think, and they'll burn to death, or you can turn off the lava trap and they'll like... be, I don't know. I'm not sure. I want to do it so they can be, it can be automatic, and it can also be experience. I know it does have thorns and all that kind of. Sorry, I'm really tired, guys. So like, I'm running on a very severe lack of sleep. So sorry if I can't really talk that well. No different than from normal, I guess. But yeah, I just punch them and all that kind of stuff, gather experience, and then I want to do some more stuff. Actually, I really need to see the. The bottom floor here is going to be kind of low, so I might actually build this down and maybe do a progressive step down for this as well over time. But that's going to take a lot of effort, and I still have to do all this. But I'd say most of it's done. I'd say I've completed about 70% of it, probably, of the whole area, maybe about 60%. But I'm just going to, this is just going to be kind of like, just so I can get basic resource. Anyways, okay, so let's go up here. Let's break the glass and see how it works. Where's the ladder at? The ladder's here somewhere. Where? Hey, where's the freaking ladder? Oh, over here. Okay. I couldn't see it. Yeah, I'm just going to show up. We're going to break the ice, and then we're going to check some stuff out. So, yeah, guys, if you enjoyed this video, I know I've been working on this, like, the entire video. It's been cut up and over an extended period of time, and I probably make less and less sense over that extended period of time. But if you enjoyed this video, make sure to go ahead and click the like button. It really helped me out. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to break all of this ice. Now, luckily, ice is super easy to break, so I'm not too worried about it. There we go. Break that guy. Luckily, I got an efficiency book, so I put that on my normal axe here. Let's see. Yeah. It's about to break, though. I haven't repaired it yet, so it should be pretty cheap to repair. There we go. And so yeah, it's going to be about 4 or 5 layers of these platforms here, and I think it's going to be work out pretty well. I think he built this pretty much same design, at least the platform design, on a SMP, and they got about 3,000 or 4,000 items an hour or something. Which honestly, even if we got less than that, wouldn't matter at that point. Like, it's pretty much just unlimited prismarine, and that was under not ideal circumstances, like caves and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, but I think it's gonna work pretty well. Actually, there's actually a ravine underneath here that I lit up a bunch of cave systems and ravines. Hopefully this ends up working pretty well. You see the guardians are already kind of floating down towards their death and doom. And come on, guys, you got it. I think it's gonna work pretty well once we kind of get all the caves lit up and then everything else kind of done. Let's jump out down here and kind of check it out. What? Oh, they. Okay, I see. Yeah. Hey, get out here, guys. Ah, dang it. But yeah, I think this is gonna work pretty good. Get out of here. can I actually see? They bounce around so much, you can't actually stab their faces from inside of here. I'm out to work on it. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and call it here, guys. If you enjoyed, make sure to go ahead and click that like button. Make sure to subscribe. I love y'all's faces, and I'll see you guys next time. If you guys like the way this is looking, also I kind of borrowed his color scheme, but I've been using the color scheme for the base, like the same one, for a while now. So yeah, and I found his video last night while I was kind of digging this and stuff, looking up Guardian Farm designs.